I'm here in the French-speaking part of Switzerland, close to Vevey. I'm in a hotel on the mountains. I'm standing on the terrace in front of my hotel room, and I'm here with my Huawei P30 Pro and want to see what the smartphone has to offer in terms of night shooting. There are various Leica lenses in the phone, and people probably have seen all the advertisements, all the tests, all the discussions. This is a real life test. We have the moon hiding behind the clouds. It's still quite dark here, besides the fact that the moon is up, and it's quite hazy, cloudy. It's not a clear air environment we have here, and I want to see what I can get if I take photos with the P30. So I'm now in the normal photo mode. I have the resolution at 40 megapixels here, which is the main lens and the maximum you can get. And I also have the self timer on with 5 seconds. The smartphone is mounted on a tripod. Let's try to get focus here at infinity, and let's take the shot. Oh, by the way, let's deactivate master artificial intelligence. So let's try to get this done. Focus, infinity, 5 seconds countdown. Let's take the shot. Here we go. So this is what we get. Not very impressive. Probably the same level you would get on any other smartphone if you use it on a tripod. Quite noisy picture. Not very good. Maybe the reason is that 40 megapixel is not the best way to do a night shot here. So let's go to 10 megapixels, which then also offers me all the zoom options here. So I'm now at the main lens, 10 megapixel. Let's try to take the shot again. Let's, to be on the safe side, take focus at infinity again. Here we go. Look at that. Looks much better. So here is my first tip. If people want to do night photography with the P30, go for 10 megapixels, because Huawei then leverages the 40 megapixel sensor to basically combine information and get a much cleaner shot with less noise. And this actually looks quite good. Let's zoom in this a little bit. I think this is quite a nice picture. The city is a little bit blurred out. The foreground looks okay. The background looks quite nice. So you could not see these mountains with your bare eyes. It's just too foggy, too cloudy. So let's see if there is anything else we can do. There is this artificial intelligence option here. And maybe the phone gets smarter when we just switch this on. Let's see. I actually want to go as far as possible to infinity. Let's try to take the shot again. Sharpening. Whoa. Whoa, I'm blown away from that quality. That is, for a smartphone, really, really good. Look at the snow mountains here, how much structure you see. And as I said, you cannot see this with your bare eyes. Absolutely no chance. The moon is up here, hiding behind the clouds. Look at the village now. It looks much better, much cleaner, much sharper. The foreground is super sharp, super clean. You even see the structure on the roofs here. Very impressive result. I think I like a lot what I see here. This is really, really good. So what else do we have here? So we have the night mode. The night mode actually has the option for you to also tweak the ISO if you want. The night mode can also tweak the shutter speed and exposure time. It can also tweak them both. But let's try just the night mode as it comes out of the camera. If this is topping what we just saw on the normal photo mode, we need probably, I don't like that. Let's try it this way. Still not good. Is that sharp? I'm not super sure. Let's try. So this will probably take a longer exposure now. And you see it here is 24 seconds. You see actually on the right hand side of the phone a clockwise counter around the shutter button. and let's see what the phone is producing, calculating here for itself. Seems also to be quite nice what we get in terms of results. Okay, let's have a look. Also quite nice, but probably the same kind of quality, maybe if we look at the city, worse than what we had in the normal photo mode. And I don't know why that is, but actually if I look at that here, I think the normal photo mode with AI activated produced a better picture than what we see here in the night mode. Let's try to do this again. And let's tweak exposure and shutter speed here. So let's go to, it took 24 seconds before. Maybe we should check here. Actually, that's a good idea. Let's check what the ISO value was. So it took 20.8 seconds with ISO 100. Let's see if we get a different result, which would be counterintuitive if we do this manually. Let's go to 20 seconds. On ISO, let's go to 100. Let's see what it does. Let's focus at infinity. Maybe we should go to something more contrasty. What about that one here? So, let's see. So now it doesn't show us the seconds on top of the screen, but the clock count on the right-hand side around the shutter button. Interestingly, this looks to me now like it would be completely overexposed to picture, which is hard to understand given what we just saw in the metadata. So let's look at that picture. It is a nice picture. Actually, the night turned into day and it's really dark here. But if we look at that and look to the previous picture, so let's look at the metadata here. So we have ISO 100, shutter speed 20.8 seconds, and I don't know what F means here. Probably this is the aperture, I'm not sure. Let's see at the next picture. It has the same F value, 20 seconds, 100 ISO. So what's the difference between those two pictures if you look at that? Everything is exactly the same. One has 1.05 megabytes, one has 1.7 megabytes, ISO is the same, shutter speed 20, the darker one has even a longer shutter exposure time here. Very counterintuitive. If someone can explain this to me, I would be happy for a comment down in the sections, just to understand what's going on here. Quite strange. Anyway, let's look at the last mode we have here for night shots, that's the professional mode. Let's do the same experiment. Let's go to ISO 100 and on the shutter speed, let's go to 20 seconds. Let's make sure we get focus here somewhere, or maybe we do manual focus. That might be even better. So manual focus. And then let's take the shot. Let's see what we get now. And then we compare the pictures. A very bright picture again, but pretty sharp and crisp. So now let's look at the metadata. So I don't know what an F value is, 1.6. It doesn't really make sense to me. If you guys know, drop me a comment below the video. So here we have ISO 100, shutter speed 20 seconds. ISO 100, 20 seconds. ISO 100, 20.8 seconds. And that's the longest exposure time with the darkest picture. Quite interesting. Everything else seems to be the same. Histograms completely different. The file size completely different. Resolution exactly the same. So quite strange if you look at those three pictures and at the metadata we have here. Doesn't really make sense to me. So if you have a solution to that mystery, let us know. Let's go to this one here. I think after all those tests, the normal photo mode with artificial intelligence enabled produced by far the best picture. Let's take this again. Yes, very nice. Very nice picture. Sharp, crisp, clean. Quite nice. So my recommendation is playing with the professional mode can be useful, not necessarily intuitive at nighttime conditions. The night mode, not intuitive at all, because given everything else is the same, the picture we took with slightly longer exposure time is darker than the one with shorter exposure time. The normal photo mode, probably the most interesting one, if you work with AI. I don't really know what AI is doing. I mean, people say that Huawei built an incredible amount of artificial intelligence and machine learning into these phones. And they do not only optimize your usage time of battery life, observe how often you open WhatsApp and all of that, but it seems also to be useful in the photo mode. And you know, if you like the video, give me a thumbs up. If you like my channel, please subscribe. If you have comments or your own experience you want to share, please be very welcome to do so.